Welcome back to Power Lunch. As promised earlier, we're right now getting to you some clarity on the real estate market and to talk specifically about Subha Developers. Joining in from Bangalore, Mr. J.C. Sharma. He's the Managing Director of Subha Developers. Mr. Sharma, good afternoon, sir. Thanks very much for joining in and welcome to Power Lunch here. I'd just like to firstly focus on the new projects. In Q1, there were none new projects that you've launched. Can we summarize from that your inventory levels at this point are rather prohibiting you from going ahead with new launches?
Not at all, right. See, we have announced that in this financial year, we should be launching projects to the extent of about 6 million square feet. And we have already launched in this quarter one project on Bannerghatta Road. We have also launched the project in Thrissur. We have also launched the project in Coimbatore. And in the coming months and in the coming quarters, we are well on our course of launching that 6 million square feet of projects. See, these launches depend upon plan approvals and other things. As far as inventory levels are concerned, it's well within our control because we do believe that our guidance of achieving 2000 crore worth of new sales and 3.75 million square feet in area, we should be able to achieve in this financial year. And still we will have 3 to 4 years of our inventory on our current sales velocity basis.
So the inventory level that you have as of now, sir, how long is that going to take to clear up? 3 to 4 years, if I'm not mistaken?
Yeah. Because the project takes about 3 to 3.5 years to complete, and we wish to keep that kind of inventory levels to ensure that the visibility is there to us as well as to our customers.
There's been a project launch that you've done in the NCR region in the north. Do give us a quick update of what sort of response you've seen there. We understand that it's been rather successful.
It has met with a tremendous response. We felt that the price range at which we have launched this project during difficult times may have some issues, but going forward we have been able to raise the prices also without impacting our volume, and in this financial year also we feel that we are well on course of doing better than what we did in the last financial year as far as new sales are concerned in NCR.
So if you're, you're typically focused on the Bangalore market and contribution from non-Bangalore projects at this point, still, they're rather minimal. So this NCR launch, do you think it's a concerted effort or a conscious strategy on your part to now look at entering and monetizing the North?
See, we are basically an execution company and we have delivered projects in 21 cities for ourselves as well as for our clients. So there had always been a desire that NCR being the largest real estate market, we should have a presence besides in South from where we come from. So overall, the strategy of getting into NCR was to ensure that a quality developer enters into that market where with its execution track record, it can deliver superior products. And hopefully we believe that this has not only helped us, but it has also helped other developers to come to NCR and have started launching the project successfully. And like in Bangalore, where you see so many developers competing with each other, we feel in the largest market also, in the interest of the customers, good developers should be there besides the bigger developers who have already their presence, so that they can choose right products at right prices. And our this strategy definitely is working, because this year a significant quantum of improvement in our top line and bottom line, we do expect it should come from NCR sales.
Right, sir, and we wish you all the best for your North focus. But in the Bangalore region, in that space, you look at and you focus only in the luxury segment. But do give us a sense of what the realizations on average have been in that space, and if you have any plans of looking at the middle range or lower end projects.
See, if you look at Bangalore prices vis-a-vis the prices which are currently being charged by the developers in the other developed cities like even Chennai, Pune, we are not comparing it apple to apple with even Gurgaon or with Mumbai or Thane or Goregaon kind of a thing. The prices are most affordable, A. And B, within that, we also realize that the Bangalore market is the deepest market with the largest segment of a middle class who can afford an apartment at around 10 million, 1 crore rupees per apartment kind of a thing. And this is indeed, in our view, to a large segment of that middle class people to whom most of us are targeting, remains affordable. You will also be surprised that more than 55% of our customers, they do not opt for any mortgage loan. So the liquidity-wise, the affordability-wise, the Bangalore market still remains the most viable for the end consumers. And looking at the input cost increase prices and the land prices, the price increase also has been somehow calibrated, where currently we are realizing about 5,000 rupees or so per square feet for whatever we are selling.
Right. Mr. Sharma, we know that you are planning to enter into the commercial space, commercial real estate space. In light of the FDI and multi-brand retail, which has now been allowed, you know, the likes of Walmart, etc., they might need is huge spaces, commercial spaces, almost as huge as 40,000 hectares, perhaps. Do tell us, give us a sense of if this decision to enter the commercial space was in anticipation of the fact that FDI in multi-brand retail is coming.
No, not at all. See, we have always believed that the Indian consumers, at the end of the day, they will be following whatever they are seeing around the world as a trend happening. Now, FDI is required because most of the guys who are in this business and who started this retail kind of a revolution, they all need long-term capital. Fortunately, in Indian context, the next level of people, they are the best. All the top four industrial houses today, they are in the retail. And in my view, they can also invest quite a bit and could have occupied a large retail space as things would have moved forward. But with competition coming from FDI, the market definitely should become much better for the real estate developers. The demand should also increase, and maybe the developers will start getting fair price for the efforts they are putting in creating this kind of a commercial space. As far as we are concerned, we believe that our increasing cash flow at some point of time, we felt, should be directed towards another vertical, which was the commercial real estate. And in view of the improvement in our cash flows, we thought that we should also start looking into this vertical as well from this year onwards. And that was the reason behind going into this commercial real estate.
All right. Great to have that clarity going, Mr. Sharma. Thanks very much for your time and for talking to NDTV Profit. We're wrapping up this edition of Power Lunch, but stay tuned to NDTV Profit. News and updates continue right here.